What's up, everybody? We are Deanna and Phil. Deanna here is from the United States, and I, Phil, am from Germany. And in this video, we're gonna go over 15 awesome American food products and items that are hard to find in Germany.
So after being here for some time, there are a lot of things that I noticed that I can easily find in the US that are so hard or near impossible to find here in Germany. We could talk about a lot of different things, but in this video, we're gonna talk about food. So our first one is that it's hard to find boxed mac and cheese in Germany.
It's true.
This is my childhood. I grew up on boxed mac and cheese. It's the first thing I learned how to cook by myself, and it's not really cooking. Boiling water, putting the pasta in, and then putting either a powdered cheese or a fake liquidy mush cheese and mixing it all together.
Yeah, boxed mac and cheese, I noticed, is everywhere in the US in every supermarket.
There's so many brands. There's Kraft, Velveeta, there's little different funny shaped ones, vegan, there's gluten-free, lactose-free. There's so many different types of boxed mac and cheese, and I miss it.
Yeah, and when we went to the US, I tried it for the first time, and that stuff is so good. We have something a little bit similar in Germany called Käsespätzle. It's a weird type of pasta with a lot of cheese, but in my honest opinion, I don't think it can compare to mac and cheese.
Really? I want to try it. I've never tried Käsespätzle.
You will.
I think that I crave the boxed mac and cheese not because it's better, it's nostalgic and it's easy to make. And I think I read somewhere that it's banned in the EU. There's some like ingredient or something that's not
it's not the healthiest, but it tastes amazing.
It's not healthy. So the second item that's hard to find in Germany is Cheetos. I freaking love Cheetos. Flamin' Hot Cheetos are the perfect car ride snack. They are the best. Okay, and I know these products are not the healthiest for you, whatever. They're so good. I crave them sometimes. I even Googled, and there are Reddit forums and Quora threads of people in Europe looking for Cheetos. So if you can find Cheetos in Germany and get them shipped here, not for like $100, let me know.
It's these balls, right? These balls with the powdered cheese on it, which gets your hand all dirty?
Yeah, but they're not balls. Sometimes they have them like dense sticks, and got like these things.
Oh yeah, yeah.
Yeah, Takis are another one. Takis are this, I think, Mexican brand, and it's like lime and spicy, like a chip tart. Oh, so good. That's another thing that I miss a lot here.
Number three of food items that are hard to find in Germany is Mexican food. Mexican food is so hard to find here. Dude, where do I find a good burrito?
Yeah, or a chimichanga, enchiladas, tostadas, gorditas, fajitas.
None of that stuff is here, and in the US it is everywhere, and I love that. You can definitely feel that you have a big border to Mexico, and there's a lot of Mexican influence, and when it comes to food, that influence is freaking amazing. I love myself a good burrito. Burrito is my favorite, but in Germany we have them very little though, and it's very, very hard to find. Number four, ranch dressing.
Hidden Valley Ranch. The buttermilk cream dressing that'll make everything taste good.
I don't even know what you're saying.
I don't understand. It's so hard to find here. What do you eat your chicken wings and drumsticks with? It's either blue cheese or ranch. There's no other option.
People don't eat a lot of chicken wings. Maybe barbecue sauce or ketchup? Okay, so ranch dressing, it's true. The ranch dressing they have in America, I have never had here. I think the only place might be Subway. I don't know if that's the real thing, but the closest things we have is like this Thousand Isles dressing or some weird yogurt dressing variations.
That's not it.
That real ranch dressing that you showed me in America, and I think I only tried it very briefly once. We don't have it.
You're missing out in life.
Yeah, I think we're missing out. Before we continue, just a quick reminder, please support us by clicking the like button on this video. Even better, leave us a comment down below or subscribe to our channel. I can see that about 85% are not subscribed, so subscribe and you will not miss out on any future videos. Also, if you want to support us further, you can do that on Patreon. We have a Patreon page. It's patreon.com/DeannaandPhil. And there are different tiers of benefits that you can get by supporting us, and every little help is highly, highly appreciated. But back to the video.
So the fifth item that is hard to find in Germany is good, soft, chewy cookies. I mean, there are a lot of good biscuits, crackers, Bickies here in Germany, but you're missing the very soft, chewy, delicious cookies. I don't know, I feel like there are hundreds of cookie brands in the US. There's Girl Scout cookies, Grandma's cookies. I think they have a soft, chewy Chips Ahoy, Pepperidge Farm. There are so many, and I feel like the ones here are just hard. They're not cookies.
Well, I know that we have Pepperidge Farm, but I don't know about the soft, chewy ones. I'm also not the biggest cookie expert, but in the US I definitely tried awesome ones, and a soft, chewy cookie is definitely superior to one of these hard, crumbling, dry cookies.
Yeah, I feel like in the US they have stores in the malls, the Great American Cookie, a stall just for cookies.
Why haven't I seen that?
They're cookie cakes. There's so many different cookie things, and I feel like
Why didn't you take me there?
I'm sorry. I feel like I rarely see it in the bakeries in Germany, and if I do see them and I get them, they're just hard. They're not the chewy, gooey goodness that I'm missing.
Yeah, cookies. I'm missing out. Number six, strong energy drinks. And this is something that is not... And this is something we're not really missing out on. Yeah. However, the US has some crazy strong energy drinks. In Europe, I feel like we only have Red Bull, Monster Energy, Rockstar, and then a couple of cheap knockoff brands. And I think there's a legal limit of 32 milligrams of caffeine in 100 milliliter. So in one of these big Rockstar or Monster Energy cans, we have about 150 milligram of caffeine. However, in the US, in Walmart, I couldn't believe my eyes. These things like NOS, Mountain Dew, Reign, Bang, these are crazy high in caffeine. They have like 300 milligram of caffeine in a can. The cans are even slightly smaller, so it's about the double amount of a regular Red Bull. And we don't have it. It's legally limited to the Red Bull limit.
And it's interesting going through this list, learning about the different regulations that are on some of these products.
Yeah.
That you can get a lot of in the US.
Yeah, I think the US is just a little, leaves you a little more freedom of potentially hurting yourself there.
So number seven is Asian food supplies. Now, you can find Asian food supplies here, but I feel like it's very difficult to find a variety of things, and when you do find things, it's freaking expensive. Yeah. I was amazed how much more expensive soy sauce was here. Oh, it's kind of weird to me. I mean, I think if you live in a bigger city like Berlin or Munich, maybe you can find decent Asian supermarkets, but I live in South Carolina. That's not a super diverse area, and I still can find a ton more ingredients at an Asian supermarket or even at a local Publix or Bilo or Harris Teeter. Those are American grocery stores. I can find more of a variety of products than I can here. It's kind of sad. Just something simple like wonton wrappers took me forever to find.
Yeah, it's true. Like, I hear you always complaining about it. We just the other day went to an Asian supermarket store in a slightly bigger town. They have very limited supply.
Yeah, it was smaller than the room we're sitting in right now.
Yeah,
tiny.
And nowadays a lot of the new supermarkets even have an Asian section, but whenever you find something, it's just very expensive. It's not, the relation to the normal products is just not there. So overall, yes, it's pretty hard to find decent Asian supplies.
If you know of any, let us know, please. We're desperate.
Yeah, and we're not talking about this Germanized version of Asian food.
Yeah,
but like
authentic
proper
stuff.
Proper stuff.
Yeah.
Number eight, barbecue. And not just any kind of barbecue, but Southern style barbecue, which I had no idea what that was until we went to the US and you took me there. And I'm very thankful that you did that. Southern style barbecue in the US, those are basically food restaurants, joints. It's not even fast food, right? It's just a...
It's not fast.
It's not fast. It's like mainly slow roasted pork over open fire, I guess, or in a smoker. It's like these pulled pork sandwiches, ribs, and what was that mashed potato thing called? Sweet potato crust.
Crunch.
Sweet potato crunch. What the hell is that? I thought it looked funny. It was the best thing ever.
So good.
They have vinegar and mustard based gravies that go over everything. That was one of the best food experiences I had in my life. I think every state has a barbecue.
Yeah.
That is freaking amazing, and we simply don't have these places. That is one thing that is very hard to find here, and I wish it was easier.
I want some barbecue right now.
Yeah.
Mm, baby Q.
Sweet potato crunch.
Please.
Check that video out. Link it up here somewhere.
Plug.
And that brings me right into point number nine, which is Southern brunch food. if you can call it like that. There are a lot of restaurants in the US that serve biscuits, waffles, which sounds sweet to me, but then they put like fried chicken on it, gravy, potatoes, onions, another biscuit or waffle. I was very skeptical if that stuff works together, but it's absolutely freaking awesome. It's so heavy, it's so calorie dense, it's probably not very healthy for you, but it tastes freaking amazing, and in that regard, the Americans know what they're doing.
Oh.
That was also one of the places where I had mac and cheese for the first time, and the best mac and cheese I ever had.
Oh, bless your heart, you've only tried a little bit. You've just had a little sampling of what you can get. There are so many other brunch, southern brunch dishes that you have yet to try. I'm glad you love it, but I'm also terrified of when we go to the US again, yeah, and we eat more of it.
And blow up. That was one of the worst overeating I've ever done in my life, but I wish we had it here in Germany.
So number 10 is graham crackers.
Graham.
It's such a silly thing, and I really didn't realize that it was missing here in Germany until I wanted to make our s'mores video, and then I was like, where the heck are all the graham crackers? They're none. I cannot find them. I googled it, and people are on forums again looking for graham crackers.
Yeah, you were looking all over for these graham crackers for the video, and I didn't know what you're saying. You told me about that stuff, and I tried to google it. What's graham cracker? And then it comes up, it's a graham cracker.
It's a graham?
It makes me a little mad. Why is it called graham? Graham cracker and not graham.
I don't know why it's called that.
What says graham cracker? Graham cracker.
Graham. Number 11 is going to be Cheez-Its, Goldfish, Whales, any cheese-flavored crackers. They are so hard to find here. I don't know why. As a child, they were like our field trip snacks. They would just give all the kids a little bag of Goldfish and you're good to go. And it's just near impossible to find here. Like, we in the US, we
Goldfish.
Have aisles of these things.
Oh, is it that Goldfish from the Friends episode with Chandler's new crazy roommate that put a goldfish in the tank and it was a cracker? Is that what you're talking about?
Yeah.
Yeah, goldfish. Like, when you tell me goldfish, I think about a fish in the pond.
It's so iconic, and I think, I bet if you were to take a poll, like 99% of Americans would know what goldfish are.
Let's see, we'll take a poll up here. Do you know what a goldfish is? And we're not talking about the actual animal. We're talking about the little cracker fish that Chandler's crazy roommate Eddie put in the aquarium when he was out of town. Number 12. Hershey's chocolate and Reese's. And when we say Reese's, we talk about these Reese's peanut butter chocolate cup
there's
things.
There's no wrong way to eat a Reese's.
Exactly, but there's also no right way because I think they're horrible. So in the US, we tried both and I'm not a fan. And the weird thing is we found those in a lot of Asian countries, in Thailand and 7-Eleven, they're everywhere, especially the Hershey's chocolate. Both of them, though, very hard to find in Germany, and they are a huge staple in the US, right?
Yeah, I mean, I'm not really complaining about the Hershey's chocolate bar because I think there are way better options of chocolate bars, but yeah, hard to find here. Number 13, bagels. Bagels. Delicious. Those.
With a hole in it.
With a hole in it, sometimes a little small one. Anyways, it's understandable why it's not in Germany as much. It's something I grew up with. It is my childhood. It is my adulthood. It's every hood of me. It's like my life. As a child, I loved the cinnamon raisin, and then in college, I loved the Asiago cream cheese, and then as an adult, I love a good everything bagel with cream cheese and lox. That's my life. It's so hard to find a bagel here.
That's true. So Germans traditionally go for the classic bread roll, the Brötchen. I thought first a little bit like a bagel, but without the hole, but it's not. The bagel is denser,
it's
right?
It's way denser, yeah.
So I really, really like bagels, and you can buy them to bake them in your oven, but they're super not common. Like, it's very hard to find a bakery where you can get a bagel, and it took me to go to New York City last year with you to learn about how awesome bagels can actually be. You're like, I'm just getting an everything bagel. I was like, what the frick is an everything bagel? Like, bagel with everything on it?
No.
What is it? But it's just the seasoning of the bagel, and I became a big, big fan of the everything bagel with cream cheese. Freaking awesome. Bagels are amazing and they're very hard to find in Germany. Point number 14, cakes and pies. And I think this is a tough topic because both countries, Germany and the US, have a very strong cake culture.
Cake.
And in Germany, we mostly distinguish between doughy cakes called Kuchen and creamy cakes, and we call them Torte or Torten. And I think in America, the cake and pie thing is a little different. I can try to summarize it like, in America, I feel you just use more stuff. They're bigger, they're more loaded, taste better in my opinion, but are probably also unhealthier. It's a little bit like German cakes on steroids in America.
I think it depends. I have yet to try all of the cakes here, but I feel like the cakes are just different. They have different density, it's different texture. Like, my favorite cake is carrot cake, yeah. And I cannot find a good carrot cake. If I've tried it here, it's falling apart, it's not dense, it's not moist enough, it doesn't have the cream cheese frosting that I love with it. Yeah, and I think going back to the pie thing, pies are huge in the US. I mean, my sister works at a pie shop. They have savory and sweet pies. You can do all these different types of pies. I mean, you have the classic apple pie, blueberry pie, any type of fruit pies, but then you can get into shepherd's pie, sweet potato pie, curry pie, pumpkin pie.
That's such a foreign world to me, and I really want to try that. I still do not fully understand what a pie is compared to a cake.
Crust.
Sounds amazing.
So our last point is number 15, Pop-Tarts.
Tart.
Okay, as a kid, I was never allowed to have Pop-Tarts. If we did get the Pop-Tarts, we got the ones without the icing on the top. My mom thought they were healthier than the icing ones. They suck. The ones with the icing are the best.
It's this thin filled thing you put in the toaster, right?
Yeah, you put it in the toaster and it has like some type of filling in it, and icing should be on the top of it. In college, I ended up buying a lot because I was like living out my childhood dream. You tried a pumpkin Pop-Tart, remember?
Yeah, I remember. It's a little overrated, I think. I think it's your
memory overrated.
Of childhood and college. They're not my favorite, but you're right, they are not here.
I like them. So I know with a lot of these items, you could probably make a super fresh home-baked bagel or super fresh home-baked cake or whatever.
Nobody does that.
But I'm just talking about the convenience. Like mac and cheese, obviously homemade is better. But what if I just want a convenient, easy boxed mac and cheese? I can't get that.
Anyway, comment below if you agree with our list. What else are we missing out here in Germany compared
food-wise.
To the US or to other countries? Also, let us know which one of these things your favorite is.
What do you miss?
What do you miss?
As always, thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you next time.
Bye-bye.
Bye. I wanted to say thank you to all our patrons who have joined our Patreon page. From our older patrons who have been with us since the beginning to all our new members, we really, really, truly appreciate your support, and it really does help to run this channel. So thank you guys so much for your support. We hope you all are staying safe and healthy during this time. As always, thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you next time. Bye!